Will surgical robots be tiny or huge by 2030? Meet Per Vigard-Naseth, Chief Executive of CMR Surgical. Per is on a mission to revolutionise surgery by using robots. And meet Michelle, a surgeon with 15 years' experience. I'm Simon Darling, welcome to Life in 2030. This is one of my weekly prediction videos. At the end of it, I show how huge surgical robots will be by 2030, on a scale of 1 to 10, based on looking at the technology, companies, how much to love, and jobs. First, let's look at whether the three main technologies needed for surgical robots to be huge by 2030 will be solved or unsolved. The technology Per needs to robotically cut the body when operating is definitely solved by 2030. Today, he already uses tactility technology robotics to determine the exact place needed to operate. The sensing mechanism scans the surface of the body through parallel passes to assess the surgical area. The robot calculates and determines the precise length to be cut, and then performs a sequence of short cuts before making the full incision. The technology that the robot needs to fully operate on people by 2030 may be solved. Today, Michelle operates on the patient with her hands. How does Pear's robot operate? It operates under the supervision of a medical professional using artificial intelligence image recognition to visualize the operating area, and then uses a gripper to retract the skin and then expose the damaged tissue, while the second gripper reaches in to fix it. Pear's robots perform surgeries, including appendix removal, gallbladder removal, and stent insertion surgery. Currently, the robots are operated by doctors, but one day they will do it all in a fully automated way. The technology Pear needs for his robot to sew up the patient will be solved by 2030. The robot breaks down the sewing process into simple movements it cautiously follows. A force sensor mechanism ensures that the needle is not pushing down too hard, thereby avoiding tissue damage. The optimal place to sew up is directed using dots of infrared bioglue, allowing it to track the tissue when it moves and to adjust every stitch. In a sewing accuracy test on pigs, the robot sewed more evenly and with more secure stitches than those made by surgeons. Because the technologies needed are mostly solved, this points to surgical robots being at the huge end of the scale by 2030. Now let's look at companies. Are there plenty of unicorns, startup companies worth more than $1 billion? And are there big multinationals that are active represented by this elephant? Pear's company CMR Surgical is a unicorn worth more than $2 billion. Pear joined in early 2020 from ABB, the engineering conglomerate, where he was in charge of their robotics division. CMR's laparoscopic cutting robot is called Vicarious. It launched commercially relatively recently in September 2020, with over 1,000 surgical procedures completed in hospitals across Europe and Asia. Riverfield is on its way to becoming a unicorn. It is the first Japanese company to develop a surgical robot called Amaro. It is an endoscope holding robot controlled by a surgeon sensing vertical and horizontal movements of the surgeon's head through a gyroscope that the surgeon wears. Amaro is one of the first surgical robot companies to use pneumatic air pressure. This enables higher precision. Vicarious Surgical is a unicorn. It went public on the New York Stock Exchange in April 2021. Bill Gates was an early investor. The FDA has given approval for their robot, which includes fingers that replicate human motion. It's amazing watching it sew. Look at that. There's plenty of corporates that are active, including Johnson & Johnson, Intuitive, and Medtronic. Some are acquiring companies. Johnson & Johnson bought Auris Health, a developer of medical robotics, and one of the first to aim to operate on lung cancer. Medtronic, the world's largest medical device company, is buying startups, including the Israeli robotic spine surgery startup Mazo Robotics. Intuitive has grown to become a corporate worth more than $50 billion, having pioneered one of the very first robotic surgery systems called Da Vinci way back in 1999. With more than 7 million surgeries completed since then. Because there are plenty of unicorns, and because multinational companies are so active, this look at companies points to surgical robots being huge by 2030. If you're enjoying this, hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out on the fascinating new predictions I make each week. Now let's see if there's lots to love and give surgical robots 5 stars for, and few reasons to give it 1 star. It's 5 stars for precision. Surgical robot-assisted surgery can give more precise cutting and sewing and a greater range of motion and dexterity. 5 stars for fast recovery. Smaller incisions mean less trauma and smaller surgical scars. Patients frequently go home 1 to 2 nights after robot-assisted surgery, compared to longer stays with traditional open surgery. 4 stars for enabling remote surgery. Telesurgery already exists, but robots make it even more widespread, allowing the expertise of specialized surgeons to be available to patients worldwide, without the need for patients to travel beyond their local hospital. Robotic surgery is already growing fast, with robot-assisted procedures involved in more than 15% of all general surgeries in the US today, up from only 1.8% in 2012. Because there are good reasons to love robot surgery, it points to it being at the huge end of the scale by 2030. Now we look at jobs. For surgical robots to be huge, there'll be lots of jobs being hired and fired. Surgical assistants may one day be fired because robots will have replaced them. On the hired side, the CMR Surgical team has a lot of vacancies. There's 25 listed on LinkedIn at the time of recording, including in electronic engineering, software engineering, occupational safety, mechanical engineering, marketing, and as technicians. It's well worth looking at LinkedIn if you're interested in getting a job in the surgical robotics field. Helping you make good career decisions is a big reason why I'm doing this Life in 2030 channel. Jobs in fast-growing new sectors like surgical robots are exciting and more secure than in older sectors. I was fortunate to get into the newly emerging e-commerce sector with eBay in its early days and have benefited ever since. Jobs in the surgical robotics field are all around the world. CMR Surgical is located in the UK, Riverfield in Japan, Mesa Robotics in Israel, Intuitive and Vicarious are in the US. You could set up some job alerts for these companies. It's easy to do on LinkedIn, and click to have a look at the My Life in 2030 course that people absolutely love that I lead. Because there's plenty of jobs being hired and fired, from a jobs point of view, surgical robots is at the huge end of the scale. Now we've covered all 4 sections, it's time for me to make a prediction. We've seen the technology needed for surgical robots is likely to be solved. There are plenty of unicorns, there's lots of reasons to love it, and new jobs are being hired. This means that on a scale of 1 to 10, surgical robots is at the huge end of the scale by 2030, at an 8. To get updates on predictions, sign up for my Life in 2030 newsletter. Click the subscribe button to see our regular flow of fascinating new predictions. And go and have a look now at this prediction or that one. They're great. I'll see you in the next video.